Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. I'm joined by Kirk Pepperdine, who's going to talk to us about maps. Kirk, do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and about maps?
Hi, Brian. Thanks for having me. I'm a principal engineer in the Microsoft Java Engineering Group, and we're responsible for building OpenJDK for consumption within Microsoft. And in this session, we're just going to look at the ins and outs of maps in Java. The map data structure holds key value pairs. The keys must be unique. In other words, a key can only show up in the map once. However, the values can show up in the map multiple times. In Java, we have several different implementations, of which I've listed a few here. You can go into the Java doc and find the other implementations. The primary difference between each of these implementations is the underlying representation. Behaviorally, they should be about the same. Now, some will not maintain order, others will. The concurrent hash map is thread safe, the others are not. If you use them in a multi-threaded environment, you have to treat them accordingly. Let's take a look at some of the basic map operations. So I'm going to declare a map, and I'm going to parameterize it. I'm going to have a key of integer and a value of string. And then let's just call this a dictionary. And we're going to say this is a new hash map. Okay, so the interface is a map, and the concrete type is hash map. Let's add some data into this. So I'm going to do a dictionary put. I'm going to put one comma and the text value of one in here. Now, this is a primitive and that is an object. So this feels like I'm violating the API and I should have a syntax error here. But in reality, what's happening is that under the hoods, this one is being boxed as if it was a capital integer. And that allows us to not have to say new int with one and, you know, go through that mess. We can just simply put it in this way. So let's copy this and I'm going to put it in a couple more times. I'm going to say it's slot key 2 and key 3. I'm going to put in 2. And I'm going to put in 3. Okay, now that we have things in the map, how do we use it? Well, one of the things we can do is we can figure out how big is it. So I'm just going to do that with a size method. So it'll give me the answer in this case, hopefully 3. And the other thing I might want to do is just say, okay, what's actually in the map? So there's a couple of ways I can do this. So I can just print out the map itself, and that will work in this case because it's really small, but if it gets to any significant size, then it's not going to print out the entire map. It's only going to give you the front and elements. The other thing that we can do is we can just go through every single key value or every single value that's being held onto in the map and do something to it. So Let's just by iterate through the keys here. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in dictionary dot. And in this case, I'm going to try to get the key set. And for each key, I'm going to print out the value that's associated with the key. Okay, so that's one way I can do it. There's another way I could do it, but this is going to be a lot more expensive. So we can just change this and say this is our values. And in this case, we're going to get a collection of the values. And let's just change that around. And in this case, I don't have to pull it from the dictionary. I can just print the value like this. And there's a shorthand notation I can use with this, let's go for it. Okay, so when I run this, you You can see that I have length of three. Here's my two string representation of this collection. And I have 1, 2, 3 for the first set, and I have 1, 2, 3 for the second set. Now, there's a one-to-one association with the key value, and the keys can only show up once, which is why we have a set here. And whereas when we look at values, we can have more than one value in the hash map. So let's play with that. So let's say that we take one, and we're going to redefine that as 4. And then I'm going to add one in here. 4, comma, and I'm also going to declare this to be 4. I'm going to run this again. And what do we have? Length 4. Here's our internal representation. So you see 4 has shown up twice here, and we have 2 and 3. So 1 is associated with 4, and 4 is also associated with 4. Finally, I can change the concrete implementation as long as it implements the map interface and is parameterized. For example, I can put in properties, but properties is a very old class and is used all over the place. So it was very difficult to parameterize this when parameterization came into the language, and therefore it's not parameterized. And I can't use properties this way. I'd have to deparameterize my declarations over here in order to have this code run. However, if it is parameterized, for instance, I'm going to use a concurrent hash map. This would be a thread safe implementation of a hash map and run it. You can see that it gives me the exact same behavior.
Thanks, Kirk. That was great. Please check out the rest of the topics in Microsoft's Java for Beginners series.
Thank you, Brian.